Good day, friends. Good day, humans. And good day to all of the beautiful, complacent, fascistic, loving YouTubers. I know many of you will get insulted because I call you a fascist. Well, let me elaborate. For me, the fascism and fascistically behaving people are the ones who are complacent, who can be put in subservient position without even questioning why they have to go around and kill the nations. Why they have to go around and impose their so-called Ariel's attitude. They are better than others. Yet, why this came to life and why the fascism was raging for, let's say, since 31 until the 45, 46, mid of Europe, and then immigrated to America. Physically and allegorically speaking, the fascism of the complacency to do what governments tell you turned to be, you know, now primary source is within Americas. Now the fascism is raging on YouTube, on internet, in this big corporate transcontinental, trans-intergalactic companies that they are just, don't know, feeding of all of the complacencies ever produced on this planet. So, title, Their Tubes, Fascistic Censorship. And what are you fuck going to do about? Meaning, Their Tube, I call this that you know as YouTube, because it was never your tube, it was always their tube. Reason why, it's you gave it away. You created everything, you created all the videos, you spent time, hours, you know, weeks, years, and they kept a little carrot in front of you called monetization. We'll monetize your videos and you'll make a fortune. It goes right in front of your nose and you come closer, you want to bite it, and it goes a bit further. Then what to do? Then I have to bend a little bit more, and then you bend a little bit more, and then somebody just smack you from behind. And this is a good thing, because the same one who's holding the carrot is smacking you from behind. Allegorically speaking and literally speaking, the same ones who are giving you a chance, let's say, to put your videos or make a money on line or whatever, make money doing the videos, they can just say, not anymore. You have to be white and you have to be Nazi and you have to be, don't know what was like, hating everybody, but whatever, and then maybe you'll have a nice uniform and you have a gun and you'll shoot everybody who will tell you. And then you'll be very, very complacent and very, very calm, afraid for your life, because this is how they operate. They organizing a fear mongering technique through centuries. I'm talking through millennia, through tens of thousands of years, always the same. Stick with a carrot and on the back you have your, you know, slapping mechanism, killing mechanism. So what is YouTube is doing now giving a slaps on your back, on your bum, on your ass, you know, behind your ears, as my father sometimes had a tendency to smack me because I was very unaware when he's behind. I just had like a big boom and my ears started ringing, and I don't know why. I mean, I know why, because I was not complacent. So, going back to the people, who are now, let's say, whining and crying about Bitcoin. I'm sorry, Bitcoin. About YouTube channels were demonetized, canceled, blocked, not shown, they're stealing their clicks, likes, and so on. Subscribers, I mean, million techniques. They're giving warnings, and they have a little cartoon character dude like a lawyer in the YouTube video when your video gets a first strike or whatever, second strike, and this one goes behind and smack you with a little hammer on your forehead. I mean, can you imagine? And this is educational video. He says how to do a proper videos. So what YouTube is doing now on the 22nd, or they think they're doing, they've completely changed a massive amount of channels out of the scope of public view, basically saying if you don't have 1,000 subscribers, you don't exist. If you don't have 6,000 views in 12 months, you don't exist. But we have full right to steal all of the subscribers or remove them, or actually steal all your views and put it to some kind of, you know, P. Diddy or whatever, Beyoncé crappy video, you know, crutch grabbing videos. This is the only thing that you can see, and all your clicks will go towards this because they need it. So what to do about it? Do you cry? Do you whine? Do you just like ignore? Richie Allen show was on YouTube, quite popular, a lot of following. I don't know, is it monetized or not, but I guess it was, because the advertisements were playing all the time. So why he's so ignorant and oblivious to what's just happened to him? They slap him and he says, no problem, I'll turn to another, my own thing, I'll do my own site and I'll just go from there. So I tell you, dear Alan Ritchie, or Ritchie Allen, and Sarah Westall, the girl who just interviewed him recently, they were quite, let's say she was quite bedazzled or afraid of what's going to happen to her. And there's my Patreon account, so you can sponsor me there. For what? What we have to sponsor if you're afraid to face the YouTube? What I have to hear from Richie Allen, that if he's afraid to say, you know, fuck YouTube, you will not do this to me. I'll find the ways to get all my creation back, because this was their creations. Every of the videos that has been made, it's your creation. Like, let's say we as the creators, we do this very consciously, and YouTube, so-called, providing us a platform that is not even theirs. I mean, legally and by patent, it's not theirs. Okay, big question mark after this. And what they do, they monetize it, they're profiteering, they actually doing a carrot and stick and the slap technique since 2006, when they created it. 2005, 2006 was bought by stupid Google. Creation of YouTube came from Mega Uploads, a beautiful light being called Kim.com, who really, through the PayPal, actually surprised them with how much funds he has been generated through the PayPal, posting the videos that he made a code. And then suddenly these three dudes from the PayPal decided to steal it and patent it under their name. So Google bought a patent of the YouTube. Yet I think the fight is still going on. You'll very soon start hearing much, you know, much better news that .com will come in a full disclosure of what has been done and all this really money stolen from him, basically absolutely stolen, bluntly, will be reappropriated back to him and to all the people who are actually doing the work. People downloading videos, people uploading videos, people creating videos. This machine of YouTube, the dark AI thing, just have no humanity, and we cannot question through our human views what they're doing or what they are trying to do, why they are canceling certain accounts, because they have too many views, they have too many subscribers, and maybe they are telling the truth. So you have to be very proud why your channels has been, you know, attacked, just vigorously attacked from the YouTube dark AI. And you cannot reason with the machine. You can just shut it off or tell it to fuck off. And in description of your fuck off letter to the YouTube, say fuck off means I'm allowed to tell the truth and you're not allowed to steal from me a single creative video of mine. Exactly what I've done. So, meaning, what you want to do, this is my third channel on YouTube, since like full, like started probably 2007, very early. And 1,100 videos, let's say in total, I have 637 views in total. So I have less views than the videos created. Not that I'm in any way upset, not that I like earn tremendous amount of the fortune through the YouTube stealing, but I'll show you that there is a possibility that you can revoke every single video of yours. First of all, even if it's canceled, even if it's blocked, even if it's forbidden in certain countries, you can check your videos replacing the word you by hook, H-O-K, tube.com, and go from there. Put the code of your video. It is absolutely on the cloud, and it's not the cloud that YouTube is controlling, and it's counting whatever how many clicks is done, so they can show it to the advertisers. Even the most of the clicks on the YouTube are done by bots, by the machines, and it's just like fakery after fakery. Facebook had the same freaking problem. They lost tremendous amount of advertisers because the advertiser starts questioning, how come in 35 seconds when the video is shown you have 2 million clicks on it? It's impossible. There's not so many people like awake at that time, and they create 2 million clicks. So it's done by the bots, by the, let's say, another layer of computer program that is just there to do the clicking. But using a swear word in a YouTube, it's one very interesting, let's say, technique. You put in title, you know, fuck you YouTube, they will accept it, because in description you can say really what fuck you YouTube means. It's like doing an agreement with anybody else, with any kind of legal matter that you do. If you do your descriptions on the end of your document and you're saying morality means this, disclosure means that, you know, defendant means that, and you put your words, not going from Webster Dictionary or now in a YouTube legal disclaimer that they can do whatever, they can fuck you upside down just because they gave you a platform. But this platform is you, so there's no way out of this but to fight, to stand tall and tell the YouTube to fuck off your creation and call every single creation of yours back to you.